The Bible.
In the beginning.
But Abraham.
Moses looked back at those who followed him.
For unto you is born a Savior.
But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost.
Hello, friends. Welcome to Bible Broadcasts, vintage stories and carols from the golden age of radio. I'm John Henderson. Join me for an in-depth look at the life of Christ as heard over the airwaves of the 20th century. Today, the second in a series leading up to Christmas. This is the story of Mary and Joseph from Matthew 1. It also includes the conclusion from last week's story of Zachariah and Elizabeth from Luke 1, from a December 1947 broadcast. The episode takes a short biblical account and expands it into a longer drama that adds detail and emotion. But before we get to our story, a Christmas carol. Here is O Little Town of Bethlehem from a December 1947 broadcast.
O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. For Christ is born of Mary, and gathered all above, while mortals sleep, the angels keep their watch of wondering love. O morning stars together proclaim the holy birth, and praises sing to God the King, and peace to men on earth. O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in. Be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels the great glad tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel.
And now today's story.
About the birth of that child who was to live the greatest life ever lived. Yet another child is to be born before him to herald his coming, one to be known as John the Baptist. In the home of the priest Zacharias in Judea, the maiden Mary waits. And while she waits, her cousin Elizabeth sits by looking at her.
Are you frightened, my dear?
No.
I wouldn't blame you if you were. It's an honor in the sight of the Lord, but a deep responsibility, too.
My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit has rejoiced in God my Savior. For he hath regarded the humility of his handmaid. For behold, henceforth, all generations shall call me blessed.
Of course, child.
Elizabeth.
Don't move, dear.
Elizabeth. Elizabeth, where is she?
Joachim, your daughter is here and safe and well. Now, come in, come in. We can talk later.
Mary. Mary, how good to see you safe.
Mary, leave us two alone.
Well, what is it? What's wrong?
Surely, Joachim, you must know that something strange has entered our lives. My having a child after all these years. My dear husband Zacharias struck dumb.
The hand of the Lord is in this.
And if the hand of the Lord has touched Zacharias and myself, couldn't it also have touched your own dear Mary?
Mary? Sweet, simple child. True, we're of the house of David, but who am I? What is my family to attract the hand of the Lord?
Perhaps it was willed that way.
What way? What are you talking about?
Perhaps she was chosen because she's a simple maiden of Israel.
Chosen? Chosen for what? She's my daughter. I've chosen to fetch her home where she belongs.
She no longer belongs to you.
In heaven's name, who does she belong to if not to us?
She belongs to the Lord, Joachim.
Elizabeth, bearing your first child seems to have done strange things to you.
Joachim, if you don't believe me, ask Mary herself.
Yes. Yes. That's exactly what I'll do.
It'll be time to start out soon, Joachim. Joachim, do you hear me?
Yes. Yes, I hear you.
It stunned you.
It has. The angel Gabriel appearing to my daughter, appointing her chosen of the Lord.
Will we ever get used to it?
But why my family? True, we've been good people for all the generations, but to be so highly honored, do we deserve it?
Moses was a foundling, David a shepherd. The Lord seems to reach out for the lowly on which to bestow his blessings.
Then it will be so. Now I must take my daughter and bring her home. And Elizabeth, I'll send Anna to you. She'll be a great comfort to you in such a time.
It would be good to have your Anna here with me.
Then she'll be here. And now, Mary. Mary, child, it's time for us to start on our way back home.
And Anna, we must be mindful of Mary every moment of our lives.
Of course, Elizabeth. But you must think of yourself now and your baby, which is coming.
It will be soon. Soon.
And still, Zacharias can do no more than sit and stare at you. How much there is he must want to tell you. And he can say nothing.
Zacharias is content. I know that. After you've been married to a man as long as I have to him, there are certain things you know, even without a word.
Poor Zacharias. But now you're tired. I shall darken the room and you'll get some sleep now, Elizabeth.
Thank you, dear. Anna,
shh, my dear. It's all over.
A son?
A son.
It had to be.
Shh, don't talk anymore, my dear.
The preparations? The feast?
All being arranged. We're even discussing the name.
The name? No.
Shh, now, we're only talking about it. Nothing will be decided without you and Zacharias.
Zacharias?
You want him now, don't you?
Yes.
Then I'll bring him in. But don't talk too much.
Too much? I must do all the talking.
I'll bring him in. Zacharias?
Zacharias. A son. A son. You're pleased. I can see it. Thank you, Zacharias. That's a kiss. I shall treasure the rest of my life.
Now, Elizabeth, out of the kitchen. The feast is all prepared. There's nothing for you to do.
You don't understand. I still can't grasp it. A naming feast in my house.
You are to lie down, Elizabeth. You can do all your wondering when you're stronger.
Oh, Anna.
You must save your strength. There'll be many guests, and that's always tiring. Get your rest this morning while you can.
But it's been 8 days. I'm strong again.
I never yet saw a woman who was as strong as she felt.
I can't win out with you, Anna. Yes, I'll rest. But one thing must be decided now. The name.
All the relatives talked about it. In view of the special circumstances, we thought it might be well to call him Zacharias after his father.
No. No.
But now, there's nothing to get excited about, my dear. It was only a suggestion.
No. We mustn't call him that. We can't. There is only one name for my son.
Only one name?
Yes. The child shall be called John.
John? John. Why, there's no one in Zachariah's family or yours but that name. Who gives a child a name that's not in the family?
Custom will have to suffer this time. My child must be named John.
There's no sense to it. I shall talk to Zacharias about it.
Then we'll go to him together.
Zacharias, listen to me. This is important.
You needn't talk to him that way, Anna. He hears and understands perfectly. It's just that he can't talk.
All right, I'm sorry. Zacharias, there's a very important question. The naming of the child. We must decide within the next few hours. What are you motioning about?
He's making a sign with his hands. I think he wants to write something. Quickly, fetch a writing tablet.
Of course, Elizabeth.
Zacharias, this is my fault, all of it. I have a strange impulse about the naming of the child.
Here it is. The parchment, the quill.
Now, Zacharias, write.
One word. Is that all? Is...
Oh, what does it say, Anna?
One word. One name. The name is... John.
John. The name I said. The name I felt it had to be. I never talked to Zacharias about it.
I Elizabeth.
Zacharias. Anna, did you hear?
I'm free, Elizabeth. Free of the prohibition placed on me by the angel Gabriel.
Oh, the angel Gabriel?
He came to me. There in the inner temple while I was performing the rite of the burning incense.
The Lord protect us.
I had entered the Holy of Holies. I set the flame to the incense. I stood there saying the prayer, and my own prayer as well. And what would my prayer be but that we should have a child?
I was praying too, Zacharias.
And as I prayed, I felt the presence. The angel spoke to me. He said, "Thy wife, Elizabeth, shall bear thee a son, and thou shalt name him John."
Somehow, in some way, the name came into my mind and stayed there. Glory to God, for all this is his doing.
We are not alone in this, Elizabeth.
What do you mean, Zacharias?
Our child, who lies now in his crib. He's the forerunner.
The forerunner of what? Of whom?
Of the Messiah. For the Messiah is already on the way.
The angel told you too?
The angel told me more than I understood then. He told me that my child should be the one to go before him who would fulfill the prophecy of Elias. That my son should prepare a perfect people for the Lord. The child which is Mary's and the child which is ours, they've been sent together, these cousins, Jesus and John.
May the Lord be praised.
And the dumbness which struck me, the fault was mine, for I didn't believe.
You questioned the angel?
Yes.
And so you were struck dumb?
Until the day that these things shall be fulfilled, the angel said. And so it was.
But now you can speak again, Zacharias. You can speak. My heart is full to overflowing with the kindness the Lord has visited on this house.
Now, the child.
Lying in the crib.
Then I must go to him.
The child sleeps?
Sleeping or awake, the child must receive my prayer. Come.
Shh. If I could only let him know.
Please, Elizabeth.
I'm sorry, Zacharias.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he hath visited and redeemed his people, and hath raised up a horn of salvation to us in the house of his servant David. And thou, child, shalt be called the prophet of the highest, for thou shalt go before the face of the Lord to prepare his ways, to give light to them that sit in the darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Anna, on the way, be careful. There's so much evil abroad in our land today.
I'll be safe. Don't worry.
Anna, one can't take too many precautions in this land. There are bandits within the law as well as without. The Romans and Herod's legions. It's evil piled on evil.
You two needn't worry about me getting home. It's after I arrive there that you can pray for me.
It'll be no easy job you have ahead of you.
Such a great responsibility for us to face. Are we worthy of it?
We've all been called to great responsibility.
Somehow, those the Lord appoints find the strength to do his bidding. I trust Joseph is worthy of Mary and of the great responsibility that will be his.
We shall never know till he's told. And it will be done as soon as I arrive home.
Goodbye, Anna. You've been a comfort to me through a difficult time. I wish I could do as much for you.
You can both help. If you'll pray for us. For Mary.
We will, my dear. We will. God be with you on your journey.
All that happened to Zacharias. Now you know everything, Joachim.
And our daughter, she serves the Lord in the most important way in this great moment.
And within us is a secret that burns. The Messiah is coming. And only we know.
We'll do our part in this, Anna.
There is more than our part to consider.
Joseph, I've thought of that myself.
We must tell him.
It's my duty. I'm head of this household.
Then do it, Joachim.
This very day. I shall go down to his carpenter shop now.
Joseph! Joseph, peace be with you.
Peace to you too, Joachim. Come in out of the hot sun.
And how do things go, Joseph?
Well enough. Sit down, be comfortable. Comfortable as you can in the midst of the shavings and chips of wood.
Joseph, there's something I must talk to you about.
I suppose there must be a great deal for us to talk about. Well, feel free to say anything you have on your mind.
Joseph, it's not easy to say what I have to say.
What do you mean, Joachim?
Things have changed. A wonderful thing has happened.
Nothing you've said helps me to understand.
Because I can't tell you. Come, Joseph, come home with me. Perhaps there I'll be able to tell you.
Joachim, have you...
No, Anna. Not a word of it could I tell him.
Please, Anna, what is it? It must be a terrible thing the way you both talk of it.
Terrible? No. Wonderful.
Then why does everyone act so strange?
Joseph, this is a great test for you. Now is the time you must hear it. And from her own lips.
Mary?
Yes. Come with me, Joseph, to this room. Now, Joseph, Mary has something to tell you.
Oh, Anna, you were right. In the moment that counted, you knew what to do. Mary should be the one to tell him.
Shh. I'm praying for our daughter.
Anna, I'm afraid.
And I too.
Anna, I think we should...
We'll wait.
Joseph?
Joseph? Joseph. Oh, Joachim.
You'd think the sun went out of the heavens for the last time, the way you weep, Anna.
I'm disappointed in Joseph. He said nothing. Nothing at all.
But you've been weeping all night. Can it help? Can it do any good to weep?
Weeping is some comfort.
Come now. If need be, we will bear this responsibility together. You and I and Mary. Who now? At dawn?
Let them in.
Joseph.
Joachim, Anna, you must forgive me for last night. But there are revelations too great for a simple man to grasp. The works of God are sometimes too great for any man's mind to encompass.
Joseph, you seem a different man this morning.
It's come to me, too.
What, Joseph?
Last night in my sleep, it came to me. The voice of an angel. And he said,
Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife. For that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. For he shall save his people from their sins.
So, I heard it.
Joachim!
Glory to God.
And now, Joachim, I must see Mary. I must say the things I cououldn't say last evening.
I'll fetch her for you. Mary?
Mary. Mary, how could I know that such a mission to protect the Son of God would be entrusted to me, a simple carpenter. But you need have no fear now. I'm willing to serve the Lord in my way, even as you serve him in yours. To protect you and the child shall be my life's work, Mary.
It's been months, Joachim, but I'll never grow used to just the two of us alone in this house.
It's never been just the two of us for me, Anna. Her presence is in this house, though she no longer lives here.
And soon, very soon, the child will be born.
Weeks?
Even sooner. Who knows?
Women are the best judge of things like that.
Joachim, what's that?
Trumpets. Only important edicts are heralded by trumpets. Come, we must see.
Everyone's running to see. Another of Herod's orders, raising taxes or taking our sons. What could it be?
We'll know the bad news soon enough. Come.
Oh.
Anna. Anna, don't let go of my hand. In such a mob, you'll be trampled.
Oh, I'm here. Only let's get down front so we can see the proclamation.
Let me through, please. Oh. Please, let me through.
There. He's posted there, Joachim.
If we could only get close enough.
Counted? Go back and be counted? Why? Why?
What does he mean, Joachim?
I don't know. Why should we be counted?
Oh. Now you can read it for yourself.
Let's see. Yes, it's true. A decree.
From Herod?
No, from Rome. From Caesar Augustus himself.
Then it must be all important.
Yes, it is. Come, we must see Joseph at once.
Joseph? It applies to him?
And Mary, too. Come, Anna, at once. And Joseph, it says that everyone must be counted for the tax census, and the town in the town where he originated.
And that means I must go to Bethlehem, the city of David.
And if you go?
Yes. Then Mary must go with me.
And she's going to have a child. Surely they must take those things into account?
The edict said there would be no exceptions, and Mary is now of Joseph's family. She must go.
But with the child coming?
The Romans make no exceptions. They'd have driven the Messiah himself out on the road.
Oh, poor, poor Mary.
If the edict says to go and be counted for the tax, then we must go.
But, Mary...
It's my duty to watch over her, to protect her. I shall do it. Whether it be here, or on the road, or in Bethlehem, I shall watch over her. Anna, you must help us prepare for the journey. We shall go to be counted.
Keep them, O Father,
This story continues next week. Until then, enjoy this week's closing Christmas carols.
Oh,
next week on Bible Broadcasts.
So this is the mother. And this is the child. Only shepherds, yet we are first to see the child, the Savior, born in the city of David, lying in a manger.
Thank you for listening to Bible Broadcasts. Merry Christmas.
Merry!